Gentleman Mike here, and today we're going to make a tool that I think will complement your shop. Every shop that I ever worked in or was associated with had one or two of these laying around, and they weren't used a lot, but when you did have use for them, they were a very valuable tool. And I put my raw material together and I just pulled it out of my steel pile, and it was all stuff I had on hand. So here it is. I'll show you what I've got, and I'm just going to kind of put this together roughly just to get a sense of proportion. I started out by sketching this out, and this is kind of a downsized model from what you would find in a shop, an old-school tool shop, and but it's the right size, I think, for my shop. And I have a small drill press, and so I think it'll work out real good for me. And here's the way this is going to look roughly, and we'll see what we think of this. I'm just going to put this together gently. So that's more or less what it's going to look like. And what this is, I guess you could describe this as drill press parallels. And if you have a piece that you have to drill that has an arm hanging out of it, or something hanging out of it on 90 degrees, and you have to elevate it above the table, this is better than going and hunting for parallels or pieces of steel to level this out. This is all adjustable. This arm here kind of holds the two parallels together, and you can make a parallelogram out of these, or you can move it in or move it out to clear whatever hole you're drilling. And like I say, I find that these were really a handy tool on the occasion that you needed them. And if you have a small shop, you probably need one of these. So I like the proportion. I think what I am going to do is thin down these top parallels here. I'm going to thin them down about a quarter of an inch. I don't think we need them quite that wide. These top and bottom pieces will be bolted through with Allen screws, and then there'll be two Allen screws here on slots that you can adjust them in and out and lock them together. So that's where we're at, and we're going to go ahead and go over to the I think we'll go over to the mill first, and we'll get cutting these down. It's a real simple project, easy project. Like they used to say, it's kind of a first year apprentice project, but I think it'll work out good for us. These will be primarily used on the drill press, but I see some use for this on my welding turntable too. On certain pieces, I can set it right on the turntable, and or setting up on a flat table, but I can use it for that purpose with welding, or I can even use it as a prop when I'm welding, you know, to elevate my arm up to a certain height. So with that said, let's go ahead and get cutting on these things, and we'll see what we come up with. So stay tuned and we'll get started. right now we're getting ready to put the through hole in on these bottom rails. This will be the bottom rail because I goofed up and I went through with a relief drill all the way through on the first two that I did. So now we'll call these the top rails with an extra hole in them. We'll call it a lightning hole. So let's go ahead and tap these. So we use the tapping block just to get a nice straight hole through there. Usually I don't use one of these. Once you get it started, you don't need a tapping block anymore. It'll pretty much guide itself. Whoa, I don't like that tap. It doesn't feel good. Whoa. Let's get some more oil on there. Feel that tap torquing. Oh. Oh, man. I'm gonna throw this tap away. This is a Chinese tap, no brand. I don't like it. I don't want to break that tap off in there. Get rid of this thing. I have some old taps in my toolbox here. Maybe I can find a greenfield or something thereof. This is a 4-flute. That's 5/16. Okay, let's see. Here's a 4-flute, 5 over. I don't want that. What's this here? This is another 4-flute. Boy, 4 flutes coming off the wazoo here. Oh, don't tell me I'm going to have to use that. Oh, here's a Bendix Desilie tap. That'll work better, I think. All right, so let's go in with this one. See if it makes a difference. No brand tap versus brand name. Makes a big difference. All right, one down, one to go. Why isn't that starting? Kind of a hard starter because I've got the tip ground off this because I use it for a bottoming tap. Back on. It just seems like there's a hard spot in there. Do not want to break a tab. And I used a 1/3-inch drill. I suppose I could have went a little bigger with it, with the drill. Make it a little easier. I like to use the standard drill, tap drill, when I can, because it gives you the standard amount of threads, the percentage of threads, which is, I believe standard tap drill gives you, is supposed to give you 75% thread. Alrighty, I'm gonna blow these off and I'll be right back. Okay, let's take the bluing off of these. I got a little bit of acetone here. I'm leaving the mill scale on here. This is not a real precision device. I mean, it's just used on the drill press. Acetone in the morning. Okay, these are the bottom rails here. Well, let's make sure there are no burrs on the bottom of these pillars. That are raised up by the relief drill. I don't know if you noticed when I was doing the drilling and tapping on these pillars, I forgot to drill one. I had to go back and run a drill through it. Those things happen. Okay. Now. These pillars, if you noticed how rusty and old looking they are, those were salvaged from a granary that I demolished probably 25 years ago. So they are old. I mean, 25 plus, they were probably 60, 70 years old then, so yeah. So a little bit of antique in this project. All right. This might be one that's not quite deep enough. Thank you. Okay. That's plenty deep there. Side. There's the t'other. So now, we're starting to be able to see what this thing looks like, and this strap will go down here, like so, and I have to confess I don't have the right size Allen head cap screws for down here, so I'm just gonna use bolts for now, and then I'll pick some up at the big box store next time I go into town. Let's go see what I got for bolts. This certainly is not ideal. It's better to use socket head cap screws because in most shops anyway, you're more apt to have a Allen wrench handy to be able to adjust this than a adjustable wrench or something like that. So, okay, so here's what you've got. I'm gonna check these and make sure they're within the ballpark. I might have to adjust these things a little bit so that they're as good as I can get them. I'm not gonna put a lot of paint in them. They don't have to be within a couple thousandths. I mean, if they're within 15 thousandths, that's good enough. So I'm going to get a wrench now, and I'm going to tighten this up. Okay. So there it is already. If you had something that needed to be elevated above your table, you could put it on that. You could even clamp it on there, and so it is kind of a time saver because you know you don't have to go looking around and figure out how to shim something up. It's certainly better than using a couple of 2x4s, and it does provide a little degree of safety as well. It is a more stable platform. So let's put it on the granite plate here just for the fun of it. And we'll see how parallel this thing is. I haven't checked it, so I'm gonna bring you over and we'll check it together for the first time. All right, we're live. Let's go up here. And I know you can't see this indicator. I hope you'll just take my word for it. I'm gonna come down to zero. Loose. is 0. There's minus 9. There's minus 1. And there's plus half. So it looks like I'm 9 thousandths low on this corner. And I'm well inside my 15 or 20 thousandths. And I'm going to call this good enough. So I think we're going to wrap this project up right here. And I hope you see some value in these. I hope you have got an idea for making one for yourself. And till next time, this is Mike signing out.